Hi friends, today I want to discuss about top 10 models in each chapter of JEE Mains and MCET BITSAT syllabus. So today I am selecting the chapter quadratic equation. In that quadratic equation, I just want to discuss about the top 10 models which are very important for JEE Mains, MCET Advanced and BITSAT type of exams. So the chapter name is quadratic equations. Before I am going to discuss about top 10 models, I just want to give you the basic concepts of quadratic equations. So here is the quadratic equations basic concepts. An expression of the form or an equation of the form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 is called a quadratic equation. And if a is not equal to 0, a should not be 0. And here a comma b comma c belongs to either real numbers or complex numbers. And we know that every quadratic equation has two roots, assume that as alpha, beta. Roots are nothing but these are the values of x which satisfies the given equation. These are the values of x which satisfies the given equation. Therefore, what is the meaning of it? A alpha square plus B alpha plus C equal to 0 and A beta square plus B beta plus C equal to 0. These are the roots we can say. So when I know the roots, I know the concept is sum of the roots is equal to minus b by a and product of roots is equal to c by a. But the most important and neglect concept for IIT JEE is nothing but the difference of the roots. The difference of the roots is nothing but root delta by mod a, which is nothing but under root of b square minus 4ac by mod a. This is the difference of roots. So generally these concept to everyone is neglecting. So remember this. This is one of the most important concept. So this is one concept. Difference of the roots, that is one concept. And second concept is I'm going with if the roots are given. If the roots are alpha beta, then the equation is x square minus sum of the roots into x plus product of the roots equal to 0. This is another very important thing. This is also can be written as, if I have a quadratic equation like this, I can write this fellow as a into x minus alpha into x minus beta when I have two roots alpha beta. When I have three roots, I can write ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d can be written as some a into x minus alpha into x minus beta into x minus gamma. So like this I can write. So here a into, I have to write the product of the factors or roots of the quadratic equation. So it is very important. This is the second concept to be remembered. And third concept is you have to remember about the nature of the roots. Nature of roots. So this is another very important concept for JEE mains and advanced and MCET type of thing. So it's a number which describes the nature of the roots. So the number is nothing but discriminant. Discriminant is a number which describes the nature of the root. As it is a number, I can say that number can be. So I'm writing very clearly here. The number is b square minus 4ac. I can write it as delta. And we can say the nature of the roots like this. Assume it is a number. Number can be either positive or not equal to 0 or equal to 0. So if the number is equal to 0, then my roots will become general. What is the roots of formula? Alpha comma beta is nothing but minus b plus r minus under root of b square minus 4ac by mod a. So these are the roots. So when delta is 0, what will happen is mod a is not there, only a. So what will become is, when delta is 0, you keep 0 here, therefore the roots will become alpha comma beta is minus b by a. So when it is not equal to 0, you will have again two cases. The cases are nothing but whether it positive and it's a negative. When it is equal to 0, alpha comma beta both will become equal and the value is minus b by a. And this is called roots are real and equal. Roots are real and equal. So here you put a, b, c are real numbers like that. You put a, b, c are real numbers. And delta is negative means if you keep negative number inside the root, it's called imaginary number. Therefore, the roots are called imaginary roots. Or else we can call it as conjugate complex numbers. Conjugate complex numbers, we can say. When it is positive, we can call it as discriminant is positive means real and distinct. We will get some root 3, root 5 like that. So again, here we will get two cases. K case 1, it's a not a perfect square, delta is not a perfect square, and delta is a perfect square. Two cases we will get, delta is a perfect square and delta is not a perfect square. When delta is a perfect square, for example, root 9 is there, I'll get plus or minus 3. So the roots will become, here you keep A, B, C, R belongs to capital Q. Capital Q means it is what rational numbers, and A, B, C are real numbers here. So when I have real numbers, I'll get imaginary roots and all. When I have rational numbers, I'll get two things here. When this is a perfect square, we will get the roots are rational and distinct. Rational and distinct. When it is not a perfect square, it's called irrational roots. So irrational are also called as conjugate irrational pairs. Conjugate irrational pairs. So these are the things very important. Imaginary and conjugate. I want to discuss these two things. So if one root is alpha is a plus p plus iq, so obviously other root is given and it is p minus iq. So a question is asked on 2017 JEE mains. So don't neglect this. So one root is p plus iq, another root will become p minus iq. So if I take this is nothing but one root is p minus root q, another root will become p plus root q. So these are very, very, very important models to be remembered for IIT JEE level. So this is the second model. So I'll say again, if the discriminant is a number is nothing but b square minus 4 is. So here you have to get clarity between discriminant and determinant. Determinant is a number which describes the nature of two lines. So the lines may be intersecting, parallel, or coincident like that. Discriminant is a number which describes the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation. So don't get confused between both. So discriminant is a number. So a number can be positive or equal to 0 or negative. Like that we can analyze, just revise it again if it is required. This is another concept which is very important, and they are focusing. If the roots are imaginary or conjugate complex, one root is alpha plus ib and another root will be alpha minus ib, like that p minus iq, p plus iq, they are saying that. Now one more most important is common root. Common roots. So roots are said to be common if both has a satisfying the same equation. For example, my equation is AX square, A1X square plus B1X plus C1 equal to 0 has alpha as a one root and beta is another root. So A2X square 0 plus B2X plus C2 equal to 0 will also has another root as alpha and gamma. So alpha is a common, like that. So if it is common, it will satisfy. Two cases will be there. One root common. So you substitute it there and you will get it as something like this: A1 alpha square, B1 alpha, C1 equal to 0, and A2 alpha square plus B2 alpha plus C2 equal to 0. Like this, you will substitute. From this, you can get alpha square, like this, cross multiplication method, B1 C1, B2 C2, and alpha by you will get C1 A1, C2 A2, and constant by you will get it as A1, B1, A2, B2, like this you will get. And by simplifying that, you will get it as alpha square by something common. You will get, what is the common? Apply det B1, C2, B1, C2 minus B2, C1, and alpha by, you will get it as C1, A2 minus C2, A1, which is equal to 1 by, I'll get it as A1 B2 minus A2 B1. A1 B2 minus A2 B1. So from this, by simplifying this, we'll get it as alpha square is nothing but B1 C2 minus B2 C1 by A1 B2 minus A2 B1. And alpha is nothing but C1 A2 minus C2 A1 by A1 B2 minus A2 B1. By simplifying this, we'll get a relation between. This will be only when one root is common. Now case 2, when both the roots are common, so when both the roots are common, which means that alpha alpha and alpha alpha means the equation will become identical. So both these equations will become identical. Therefore, what will happen? A1 by A2 coefficients will be same. So this is when the roots are identical. So when both the roots are identical, you will get the ratios are equal. Now the next thing is, if you observe carefully after this model, we can go for transformation of roots, or else we'll do few questions based on this, how they are asking. Question number one, I'll go with the previous JE questions only. So here is the question number one. 2 plus 3i, top 10 models, model number one, this says. 2 plus 3i is one root of 2x cube minus 9x square plus kx minus 13 equal to 0. Here k belongs to real number. Then the real root of the equation is that. Means another root. Then the real root is dash. That's a question. So try to understand. One root is 2 plus 3i. So indirectly they gave that another root is 3 minus 2i. So therefore let the roots are 3 plus 2i plus 2 minus 3i plus alpha is another root. So sum of the roots in the given equation is nothing but minus of minus 9 by 2, it's nothing but 9 by 2. So when I simplify things properly, my alpha is nothing but 9 by 2 minus 4, which is nothing but 1 by 2. So another root is 1 by 2. That is a 2015 JEE mains question. And one more most important question they're asking is, if the equations, this is another very important previous mains question, what they're asking is, if the equations have one root common, if the equations has one root common, then what is the value of A? So these are the equations. These two equations has one root common. Then A is dash. Very simple question this is. So common means x value common. No? So you multiply with x first one you multiply with x and subtract it. Therefore, if you subtract it, what you will get? So if you subtract it, x power 4 plus ax square plus 1 minus x power 4 minus ax square minus x equal to 0. So these two will get cancelled. So what will happen is, these two also get cancelled. So I'll get it as 1 minus x equal to 0. I'll get my common root. So by subtracting it, we will get what? We will get our common root. X equal to 1 is a common root. So x equal to 1 is a common root. If you put here, what you will get? 1 plus a plus 1 equal to 0. A is minus 2. So the a value is minus 2. So these type of question. This is a previous mains question. In 2016, they asked this question. And the next one more question they asked on the common roots. And take down this question also. This is another very important question based on the common root. So the question goes like this. If the two equations has one root common or one root common, and your A, B, C, R belongs to real number, then What is the value of A is to B is to C? So the question is very straightforward question. What is the value of A is to B is to C? One root is common. So here, if you observe for this question, when they gave one root common, you should be very careful. Observe the question very carefully. So here, the discriminant of this fellow is nothing but 4 minus 12, which is negative. When the discriminant is negative, both the roots should be common. So, don't forget this concept. When the discriminant is negative, both the roots should be common. Which means both the equations are identical. Therefore, what I'll get? So I'll get it as a by 1 is equal to b by 2 is equal to c by 3. Therefore, a is to b is to c is nothing but 1 is to 2 is to 3. This is a previous JEE question. So my dear students, they are asking questions straightforward, but the problem is students doesn't have a clarity in the concept. Therefore, they are always getting wrong marks, which are not their original marks, because they don't have clarity in the concept. They are missing the beauty of the mathematics. So I'll go with one more very important question. The question is like this, based on the common root only. This also previous mains question. If the equations ax square plus 2bx plus 3c equal to 0 and 3x square plus 8x plus 15 equal to 0 have a common root. So when somebody asks, have a common root, check the discriminant. So the discriminant for this fellow is 64 minus 4, 3 into 15. That's nothing but 60. 60, it's a negative, obviously. So when the discriminant is negative, both have the common roots. Therefore, both will be identical. Therefore, 2b by 8 is equal to 3c by 15. So I'll get it as a by 3 is equal to b by 4 is equal to c by 5. And the question is not this. What he's asking is, what is the value of sine square a plus sine square b plus sine square c is dash, this value is dash, in a triangle ABC. If ABC are the sides lengths, then what is the value of sine square a plus sine square b? So here it's nothing but ABC, a is 3, b is 4, c is 5, which is nothing but it's a right angle triangle. So right angle triangle, in that we can say this value will be always 2 units. We know that in the right angle triangle, that value will be always 2 units. So like that, they're asking and common root. So I'll go to the next model. So I discussed about common root. I just want to discuss the highly neglected formula of the quadratic equation, the difference of the roots. So look at here. So if this equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 and px square plus qx plus r equal to 0, these two equations as, for example, these two equations as the roots like this. This has alpha beta and this has alpha plus some 2020 comma beta plus some 2020. Then the question is, what is the value of b square minus 4ac by q square minus 4pr is dash? That's the question. What is the value of this thing? So we can easily get this question, but what is the difference between these two roots? Difference is nothing but under root of b square minus 4ac, root delta by mod a. And similarly, the difference between these two is nothing but same thing you are getting, alpha minus beta. So under root of q square minus 4pr by mod p, we can say. So therefore, if I observe these two, I can equal it both the differences. Therefore, what I'll get? Under root of b square minus 4ac by mod a is equal to under root of q square minus 4pr by mod p. So simplified means what I'll get? I'll get it as b square minus 4ac by q square minus 4pr is nothing but a by p whole square. So answer for this is a by p whole square. So such a beautiful questions they are asking in JEE mains level. So don't neglect this. This is one more important question. I just want to give one very beautiful question in the shortcut way also. Look at the question is like this. Just a minute, students. Just a minute. Hello. Yavarandi. Lakshman Nagar. Okka 10 nimshallo chena class lo unnanu. Yeah, sorry. So one of the most important previous advanced question, I can say, if x square plus ax plus 1 equal to 0 has the roots alpha 1, alpha 2. X square plus bx plus 1 equal to 0 has the roots alpha 3, alpha 4. Then the value of alpha 1 plus alpha 3 into alpha 2 plus alpha 4 into alpha 1 plus alpha 4 into alpha 2 plus alpha 3 is dash. Options they gave is a square plus b square, a square minus 4b, b square minus 4a, and a square minus b square. Like that they gave options. So this is a wonderful question based on your sum of the roots, product of the roots, or the concepts, or what you know. So you can apply different ways, and students, you can try this question. But generally, if you try this question, you will get very big way. So different methods students will approach. They will multiply everything, because once they know this, they will just apply what? Sum of the roots and product of the roots. And they will just multiply all the things, and what will happen is they will make it is very big thing. So here I want to give one beautiful shortcut or substitution method. Within seconds you can do. This is a previous advance, and recently in MCET also 2019 they asked. I think 2016 or 17 they asked in advance, and the same question they repeated in MCET also. So he says that alpha 1, alpha 2 are the roots of this. I am putting a is 2. When I put a is 2, x square plus 2, x plus 1 equals 0 means what? X plus 1 is equal to 0, whole square equal to 0. X is, that is alpha, beta is minus 1. So otherwise alpha 1, alpha 2 is minus 1. So my alpha 1, alpha 2 is minus 1. These two are equal to minus 1. Similarly, when I look at this thing, put beta is minus 2. When I keep minus 2, my alpha 3 and alpha is 1. Both will become 1. Now substitute here, minus 1 plus 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. So the, my answer should be 0. So you have to check by putting a is 2 and b is minus 2 where you are getting 0. Here you are getting 4, 4, 8. Here you are getting something 12. So here you are getting 4 minus something minus. But here you are getting answer. So this is answer, a square minus b square is answer. So generally these type of questions people are asking. So take care of these type of questions in JEE. And one more important model they're asking is based on transformation of roots, we can say. The changing of the nature of roots. So here is one, two important questions are there. I'll go with these questions first. So the questions what they are asking is in the quadratic equations only, previous mains questions I want to discuss. So this is the question they are asking. Yeah, based on difference of roots. If lambda is real number, that is a question, such that sum of cubes of roots of this is minimum. Alpha cube plus beta cube, let us suppose, if you assume it is minimum. And the quadratic equation is x square plus 2 minus lambda x plus 10 minus lambda equal to 0. Then what is the difference of the roots of the equation? This is dash. Options are 4 root 2, 20, 2 root 7, 2 root 5. Like that they are asking. So the difference of roots is dash. That's a question they are asking. First they give alpha cube plus beta cube is minimum. In the equation, can you give what is alpha plus beta? It's a 2 minus delta. Minus b by n. So minus b by a, it's a 1 minus, it's nothing but lambda minus 2. And what is alpha beta? It's nothing but 10 minus lambda. Therefore, what I'll get alpha cube plus beta cube? Alpha cube plus beta cube is nothing but alpha plus beta whole cube minus 3 alpha beta into alpha plus beta, which is nothing but, what is alpha plus beta? Alpha plus beta is nothing but lambda minus 2 whole cube minus 3 into 10 minus lambda into alpha plus beta is 2 minus lambda. So by simplifying everything, you will get it as something, whatever it may be. But he says that this should be minimum. So this will be minimum only. Here I think I can take something factors out. So lambda minus 2, I will get it out now. So lambda minus 2 whole square, you take minus out, plus 3 into 10 minus lambda. This is the thing we have. Yeah, recording, I don't know, check it. sound is coming or not. Yeah, it's recording. That sound is coming or not, I don't know. No problem, it's our YouTube channel. So, your class finished, huh? Right. Just a minute, I'll complete. So, given this alpha cube plus beta cube is minimum, which implies that I am assuming this is S. Therefore, ds by d lambda should be 0. So, what is the value you are getting ds by d lambda? Just find the derivative of it. So, 1 into lambda minus 2 whole square plus 3 into 10 minus lambda plus, I am finding the derivative, into lambda minus 2 into, here I am getting it is 2 times of lambda minus 2 minus 3. This should be 0. So from this I can take lambda minus 2 out. Therefore lambda minus 2 is 0. That is one option. And another thing what I will get it is lambda minus 2 plus, by simplifying this, I think you are getting directly lambda is another thing, minus 4. So by taking lambda 2 and lambda minus 4, you do double derivative. Then you will get the sign for minimum means, so you should get this is positive. I think when lambda is 2, you are getting positive. Use that lambda 2 there. So by putting lambda in the given equation, you will get it as your quadratic equation you will get, and from that equation you have to get the difference of roots. So the difference of roots you will get it as 2 root